Hey everybody, welcome back. We are in Crow's Perch in Velen with the Bloody Baron, who now wants us to find his wife and daughter who have gone missing. And if we do that, he will then give us information about Ciri, so pretty important. However, we do know that she stayed here, and she is in a room across from the kitchen. When she appears to be down that one. Animals.
Saw a deer trophy on a wall once. Did you know what she asked?
Haven't got a clue.
Papa, is that deer's wump on the other side of the wall?
Doesn't quite work like that.
You see it there? What's a trophy? I pity any bastard who's hurt her. I'll flay him alive.
What are the odds he's gonna let us just walk away for a bit? Apparently he's okay with it. Let's be quick about this.
So Ciri was here. A spinning top. Gretka's toy.
Okay, so we could talk to Gretka. I guess we have the toy so that maybe we can build some trust with her.
Ciri must have used these. Looks like she left in a hurry.
I don't suppose this book's gonna say, Ciri is in location X. No, The Natural Obscurity of Curses.
The Natural Obscurity of Curses by Lydia van Bredevoort. Where'd Ciri get this?
Great question. To my dear friends, Philip and Anna. Okay. From Count Laguev, Minister of Culture for the Kingdom of Temeria. So it's to the Baron and his wife. Whoever thinks curses are only ever manifestations of one being's ill will toward another is solely mistaken. Shockingly, commonplace are reports of curses cast unwittingly on oneself or on objects in one's immediate environment. The consequences of doing so can be difficult to predict. In many cases, they lead to harm or even the death of the person afflicted by the curse, or of the people spending time with the object or being on which the curse fell. That is why it's so essential to take preventative measures to safeguard oneself as thoroughly as possible against the casting of curses. As an absolute minimum, Madame Emilia Veracruz-Leon recommends cleansing oneself of all negative thoughts, striving to be one with the world, and achieving harmony between body and mind. Okay. That's very, hippie.
Dedication to the Baron and his wife. Seems they had friends in high places in Vizima.
Huh. I was hoping for more, but perhaps Gretka can give us a clue. Not that she would have told her exactly, but she may have an idea.
Shenanaking.
Gretka.
So you're Gretka.
I am. And you're Geralt.
How do you know?
Because you've white hair and a medallion shaped like a wolf.
Oh, that's
Ciri
cool.
Ciri told me about you.
Hey, we found this toy in Ciri's room. Is this yours?
Look familiar?
My top. Where'd you find it?
Ciri's room.
We'd play in her room sometimes. I was sad one day, and Ciri carved it for me. Such a shame she had to leave.
Did she say why she had to leave, or where?
You and Ciri talked a bit, didn't you?
We did.
Did she say where she was going, or what she came here to look for?
She said she was looking for you, and a sorceress. But you're here, so I guess she didn't find you. I wonder if she helped that friend of hers.
I want to know both! What friend?
Ciri wanted to help a friend. Any idea who it was?
What do you mean, who? Her friend! She said he was in trouble and that she had to save him.
Okay, so no name.
Do you know where Ciri is?
No. One day I brought her breakfast and she was already gone. The Baron told me she'd left.
Didn't ask where she'd gone?
I did. But he said I was too little and I wouldn't understand.
Aww.
But Ciri left me a gift.
A gift?
Yes, this. A green stone.
Beautiful as gifts go. Hide it well. Don't show it to anyone. It's worth a lot.
Okay, Gretka. Well, thank you very much.
Thanks, Gretka. Have fun.
But I'm not playing. I'm helping.
Okay. So now this is leading us to the Crones of Crookback Bog instead of Family Matters. So I think we're ultimately going to end up in the same place, right? But it can't hurt to have more people on our side as potential allies. Got any bug? I'm ready. Just had to use the loo.
Pam param. Pam pam param.
Do you want me to go in here?
Damn it! Jammed again.
Our bed chamber. Tamara's room is there.
Try not to make a mess. For their return, I want everything to be as they left it.
Yeah, that's fine. What the hell? Are you serious? So, is he basically telling me don't take anything?
Damn ugly for a doll. The kind you'd stick with pins to hurt someone.
I wonder if that's related to the book we just read. Candy, dolls. I don't know if I want to take anything, just based on how he said, don't take anything. Letter to Tamara. I'm taking that. Okay, we are more like a family. We support each other and help each other survive tough moments, grapple with the past. For each of us has a past, so you needn't worry about anyone digging into yours. We've got a rule, never ask more than someone offers on their own. The past doesn't matter to us, only the future does. And that and our common fight against evil and depravity, against perverse and loathsome practices of all kinds. I'm tempted. Rusty key. Oh, I got it. You know what? I'm taking it.
Incense. And an old key. Wonder what it unlocks. Anise. Sandalwood.
Ooh.
And something else. Saffron.
Now we can pick up a scent. I gotcha. Well, if that's the case, okay, it's leading back down. Let me check the other room.
Wooden candlestick. Stem's broken.
Seems relevant.
Walls a different color. Something used to hang here. That painting? Right size.
It got moved.
The Baron and his wife. Look happy enough. What's this? Gotta wonder who wanted to hide the hole. And what's on the other side.
Strange, because it doesn't look like much is on the other side.
It gets interesting. Piece of wood looks like the stem of that candlestick. No coincidence there. Fight might have happened here. I'll look for clues.
So either the Baron has no idea, or he's hiding something from us.
Fresh flowers. He expects them to return any minute. Takes hope. deep nicks, hit with a heavy object.
The candlestick? What the hell?
Huh. Rest of the candlestick. And wine stains. Somebody smashed a bottle. From Toussaint. Yeah. Erveluse. Scent hasn't died. Wonder where it'll lead me.
Okay, well. Looks like both of the scents are leading down. Is this a new piece?
Trail breaks off. Could find something else, though.
A replaced floorboard, perhaps? Talisman.
Spruce wood. Smells of juniper incense. Some sort of folk talisman. Protective. Question is, against what? Won't find much else here.
Are you gonna let me go down here? He did tell everybody that we're cool now. What the hell? Oh, this will be the key. Yep. We can use this stuff. What is this place exactly?
An altar. So, the Eternal Fires made it to Velen.
Yeah, something like that. A prayer. So we have incense, a talisman. And now a prayer. Eternal fire, which lighteth our hearts and give us light, heat us with thy warmth, dry our tears, burn our foes, embrace our friends in thy care. Give my mother health, punish my father, help me fulfill my destiny? Uh-oh.
Velen.
So, perhaps the daughter's not too fond of old Pop. I don't really want to do that in front of anybody. Even though we are cool with them, I don't want to take the chance.
Done poking around?
Yeah, so couple of things. Number one, we found a doll.
Found a doll in Tamara's room. Tell me about it.
What could possibly be so interesting about a doll?
Just tell me.
Looks like it might have been used for some sort of black magic. Where'd Tamara get it?
Black magic? Are you barmy? I made it for her. She was four, perhaps five winters old. We were in Vizima on market day and she saw the sorceress, Triss Merrick.
Oh.
Insisted she must have a doll just like her. Couldn't afford a thing of that sort, so I made the doll with my own hands.
This is Triss. No offense, but not great with your hands, are you?
Why don't you take some wooden rods? See what image of a grown woman you can come up with.
I mean, I don't know if I could do a better job. You want to tell me what happened in the room over there?
Found signs of a fight in the room. Know anything about that?
A fight? What are you talking about?
Someone was attacked. Probably your wife or daughter. Whoever it was tried to defend themselves with a candlestick. Missed the attacker. Punctured the wall instead. They tussled too.
I don't know nothing about this. That night,
I
was drunk, don't remember a thing.
Okay.
They were gone by the time I awoke.
Doubt you were the only ones in the castle. Maybe one of your men heard something?
3 times I asked those bastards if they'd seen anything, heard anything. Nothing, not a one of them.
Well, if it was you because you were so drunk that you were violent, none of your guys are gonna say, yeah, it was you that made them run off.
Whole landing smells of wine. Tell me anything about that?
One of the lads, must be. Lushies, one and all.
Give your men Ervalus?
Oh, damn it. I might have spilled it.
Marinated.
I told you I was good and marinated that night.
That's good.
Was it matter? Stench of wine in plenty of corner around the castle.
Yeah, okay. And what about this amulet, then?
Recognize this amulet?
Yes. Anna began wearing it a time ago.
Any idea where she got it?
None.
Any witches or cunning women in the area?
A Pella. Old Coot lives near Blackbow. And there's a cunning woman in Midcops, but I know little about her. She's only recently arrived.
It's Kira.
If Anna were to see someone, she'd choose the Pella, not the woman. Anna was wary of strangers, newcomers.
Well, I'm off to see the Peller.
Want to have a chat with this Peller.
Fair warning, he's a hard man to talk to. Rumor has it he killed his own father with an axe as a lad, then went batty. Now they say he sees ghosts and plows his goat.
Not really interested in his hobbies. Just want to ask about the amulet.
Wow, okay. So that, I guess, could have led us to Kira, had we not already met her. Now, I do want to figure out, first of all, what a Peller is. The Peller. As is often the case with charmers, diviners, healers, and other such cunning folk of the countryside, the Peller of Blackbow was a man of mystery, around whom encircled a great many rumors and legends. Some claimed he could commune with the dead, others that he had a different sort of familiarity with the grave, having put an axe in his father's head in a fit of rage when he was a young man. Still, others said he showed an indecent fondness for barnyard animals. All of these rumors aroused the fear and respect of the backwater peasants of Velen, and the Peller most likely did little to discourage them. Oh, this guy seems nice. Can I take this? Oh, okay, good. What are they making demands of exactly? Philip Strenger, your supply problems do not interest us. The pact we signed was clear, and the Empire of Nilfgaard demands you fulfill its terms. If you do not, our mutual obligations will be rendered null and void, and your privileges will be revoked. Well, he's obviously under some kind of pressure. How is it that we can leave this place?
White one, look like you got soused last night too.
Right, Roach, it's time for us to ride. Where exactly are we headed? We are headed to, ooh, interesting, right above Blackbow. Let's just grab any notices on the boards. Alright, so, oh, I missed it. Something about mushrooms. Damn it. Rubs for aches and more. My daughter's hands be strong and supple, and more than one man or wife complaining of witch shot or other aches of the back have come to greatly troubled and left at ease. If hard work in the fields has got you hunched over like an overburdened ox, come to our hut and find relief. Waste not our time nor yours with lecherous proposals. Good idea. Gwent, look for new players. The Sharpers, a Gwent playing society based at Crow's Perch, is looking for new members. Yes. Experience preferred, but we'll also school newcomers to the game, but not return any coin lost during training matches. For more information, see the club's chairman, Philip Stringer, known as the Bloody Baron. Well, he didn't mention that. However, when we go back to him, I would love to learn. Any man who wants to test his manliness by slugging it out in the ring, come see us and you'll fight the best brawlers around. Smithy, Fishgulper, Jonah, and the Sergeant. A Shrieker? Let it hereby be known that whoever kills the Shrieker, the monster that's wove its nest near Crow's Perch and has taken killing both men and beasts, will be given a sizable reward. Take heed that she's a dreadful, dangerous creature, and killing it with a take-a-trained fighter, not just a pack of peasants and pitchforks. And horse races. If you haven't heard, race horses around here. Anybody wants to come, talk to me now. I'll fill you in on how it works, but I'll tell you right off, you gotta pay an entry fee to race, so if you're skint, fuck off. That's cool. We'll learn about Gwent from the Bloody Baron, I guess. I am curious about where the races are. I guess we can find that after. And the Shrieker talked to the contract issuer.
Move it!
Come on now.
Let's see. I mean, we have to head out of here anyway, so... All right,
come on,
let's go, girl.
Fuck's on the love of you.
Slow down. Whoa. Faster.
Come on.
Let's learn of this Shrieker since we're here.
Greetings.
Yeah?
About that Shrieker?
Heard you have a problem. A monster you call a Shrieker.
Aye. Prowls about it does. Snatches cows and goats mostly, but it won't scorn a man if it runs into one.
Huh.
Borzoi, huntsman under the old lord, well, he said enough's enough. Claimed he'd put a stop to it, drive the beast away.
Mm-hmm.
Took a hatchet, laid an ambush for the Shrieker beyond the moat, where the fields start. It's where we found him, guts stretched o'er the crown of a tree like gossamer. Took half a day to collect the parts, put him in a grave.
Oh. Let's negotiate.
I know times are tough, but I'll need you to cough up a bit more coin.
Let's see. How's this?
I suppose I can add that.
Boom.
You are risking your neck for us.
High time a professional took a look at this Shrieker. Anyone around here know more about the beast?
Borzoi's son Simcoe does.
Oh, he was there.
His own eyes. But you might find the lad hard to chat with. Still mourns his father, methinks.
I see. Where'll I find him?
At me homestead. I took the tyke in when he lost his dad. The mother passed long ago.
Okay, well. Oh, he's out back. I'm curious as to exactly... Oh yeah, this is bang on. This would be great to do, actually. We haven't actually done a contract for a long time. Simcoe, can you tell me what happened?
Can we talk?
Let me be.
Calm down, I just wanna...
Go, I said.
I want to avenge your father, but to do that I gotta know what killed him.
Shrieker killed him. Don't you know?
That name doesn't mean much to me. Describe the beast. Tell me what it looked like.
Something like a rooster. But huge, with a lizard's tail. I heard Ruffler barking in the woods. Ran to see what you were on about. There were Dad, in the bushes. A hole through his belly. And he were moaning, screaming. I wanted to help, but how could I? How?
It's okay, just calm down.
Shush now, calm.
Calm. Calm.
Take care, kid.
Okay, so the Shrieker's actually not too far away. Does it happen to be... Well, it's off the island, then we have to go over here in this area, right? So, it's not too bad, actually. I think we'll go and check out the Shrieker first. And I guess if we're gonna do this, we should do it the right way. What I mean is, look, we're low on potions. I'm hesitant to meditate because of the fact that we just increased fortified our weapons and armor. But truth be told, it's super close by. And Roach can get us there even faster.
Go, go.
You don't like gates, hey? I guess if we're making you use your head to open them, I kind of understand. Beep, beep. Excuse me. Oh, this is gonna be off. Oh, there we go. What's with these guys just farting? Like, I guess it's just kind of trying to show us what type of people they are.
Come on, Roach.
Fruity tooty, fruity patooties. Okay. Awesome. Why are we stuck at this door?
Oh my! Nice pendant you got.
Oh. Roach just got jealous. All right, let's ride to this thing.
Where'd you come from?
Let's mentally prepare for this Shrieker. Now, this sounds to me like it's going to be a wraith of some kind, but anytime we've heard of, like, a beast in the past, they've been pretty descriptive, and I'm not sure exactly what we're gonna run into here. What do we have going on? We've got tracks.
Muzzles caked in blood. Didn't give up without a fight. Tracks are irregular here. Monster must have started staggering. Was wounded, most likely. Blood. Monster blood.
So, does that mean that it's... Oh, is it a water thing? And look how close we are to the village, too. Oh, no, they pick up over here. Oh, it's probably in those ruins or something. Oh, what's that on the wall? Is that a... Hold on a second. Is this... I don't even think... Is this leading us there? Oh, maybe. Yeah, it's a medallion. Burned ruins.
Might want to look around some.
Yeah, I'd say so. Hello. Or not. Enhanced Griffin Trousers. Okay. So, this is probably... This is probably Witcher gear. Trousers are at the bottom. Yeah, big time. But we need Griffin Trousers as well. And that reminds me, we do actually have a quest that will lead us to some gear. And I should explore that relatively soon. Is there anything else going on up here that I should know about? There's like another little room there, but... I don't see us getting in there. Okay, let's move on. It's interesting that this, like... This place is not even anywhere on our map. Like, it's not marked at all, which is just kind of bizarre. Okay. Let's get back to tracking. This is feeling a bit ominous, actually. Still near water.
Tracks lead to the cave. The cockatrice.
Oh, there's a cave. Awesome. Okay, so let's read about these shriekers, shall we? I'll take any type of advantage that I can get. Cockatrices. So, had myself 8 heifers, 5 of them milchers. Then this cockatrice sprung up nearby, and now all I got left is dried patties in an empty field. Ouch. Foolish superstitions claim cockatrices like basilisks can kill with their gaze alone. That is utter nonsense, however. A cockatrice's gaze being no more dangerous than that of an angry goose. one should instead watch out for its sharp beak and long tail, which it can whip to murderous effect. Okay. What about shriekers? Oh, let's check this here. So, grapeshot, draconid, and ard. And shriekers, same thing. The monster tormenting the residents of the Crow's Perch turned out to be a particularly nasty cockatrice. Garrett was not surprised the Baron's men had been unable to stop it. They could not possibly withstand the surgical precision of its strikes, which slice open arteries and provoke an outpouring of blood only the swallow potion could hope to stop. Okay, so I'm glad that we're stocked up. Neither did they know to force it to the ground with a crossbow, bomb, or a sign, and then evade its charge by rolling under the monster's outstretched wing. Evade its charge. Okay, we're gonna have to watch for a few things. This is gonna be hectic if we're fighting in the cave. Oh, what do we got here? Where is it? Oh, it's up top there. Whoa!
Sounds coming from above. Not about to leave. Bomb should smoke it out, though.
Oh, God. Okay. We need a Samum, Grapeshot, or Dancing Star. Let's do this.
It's not here.
Or not.
Must have fled through another exit. Gotta nab it before it gets away.
Okay.
There it is. Won't get away this time.
I guess we just chase it down? Yep. Oh my God. Okay, can we get into a little bit more of an open scenario here? Come on down, the cockatrice. Let's go. Whoa, there it is. That's sick. And freaky as hell. Can we entice him into the air? Oh, he's fast. Whoa, just in time. Let's get a little tawny owl going.
Nice.
Whoa! Shoo! Whoa. This thing is fast, too. I'd rather just jump in the air. I feel safer that way. Yikes. Hoo-hoo. That saved my ass more times than one. Is it poisoned or bleeding? Okay, bushes, not a good idea. Whoa. Whoa. This is insane! Oh, now I'm bleeding. Wait, was I not? Oh, wait! Did I just learn something there? I might have. But my health isn't regenning. Big miss. That's not happening again, pal. Oh! I'm bleeding again, are you kidding? It did say bleeding before. I don't know what's safest here. I'm a bit worried about my toxicity. Oh, just in time, but I can't really do anything about it. This is wild. Oh! Okay, hold. Oh, that was a bad time. I'm probably gonna get hit here. Can I not, here, let's get rid of this one. Swap this in with, like, Regenerates Vitality for 25. Let's do that. Or actually, I may as well get my last usage out of it. Okay, now while we can breathe. Man, that hurts. Oh, and it's- oh, I probably shouldn't have done that. Hold on. This is crazy right now. Yeah, how about water? The last thing I needed was to be drinking while doing this.
Oh.
Uh-oh. What's that? This thing is so friggin' strong. I cannot believe it. Whoa, okay.
No!
Not the right thing to do. Ooh. Oh my god, I'm tempted to just go hammer in there, but... Oh! Did it die? Did it just, like... Oh, maybe I had it poisoned or something? That's interesting. Cockatrice stomach, eggs, mutagen, trophy. That's wild. Really gotta be patient there. There we go. So we could go collect our reward, however. Oh, are we just wearing it automatically? 10% chance to dismember. It's the exact same as the Griffin trophy. Okay, it's cool. I will, well, no, I should take the bonus experience. All right, so we could just run it straight back. However, I think what we should do is find this Peller that we're looking for. He's up to the north, right? North-ish. He's out by... Oh, this is gonna be interesting. Alright, well, we will definitely head that way. I'm gonna do more of these contracts. These are awesome. We'll go towards the hut, and that'll be it, guys. Thanks again for watching, and we'll certainly see you soon. Bye.